roster already. Dreams of the double were hovering in the Banner County. Well, Ger Canning and Martin Carney were in Limerick to see if dreams come true.
Eamon Green. Great possession play by the Kingdom to work it up as far as Brian Clark. Nicely across towards Darrow Kinnaida. A real class act, given good possession. That's Dennis O'Dwyer, his first point of the match. And Kerry go back in front again. Towards Maurice Fitzgerald, his jersey has been hauled back there by Corey Gallagher. Very quickly inside towards Darrow Kinnaida. Kerry in front, into Brian Clark, lovely little, Maurice Fitzgerald, and that's at the side netting.
Again, the approach play was wonderful, a reverse pass there from O'Kinnaida onto the full forward, and Maurice Fitzgerald tries to take the near post and puts it wide.
Here comes Michael Hines, Baby John, Shannon here. Cahill Shannon getting it as far as Martin Daly, being given a lot of latitude by Mike Hassett. Useful kick, it's gone right over the bar. Martin Daly, the man who's normally good for a goal or two. That's a fine point by Daly.
Again, he takes on beautiful right-footed kick from about 40 metres over the bar.
Declan O'Keefe from Rathmore. Hines leaping up in the air. He drops it this time to William Kirby. Parlade is next. Hasn't won a Munster championship medal so far. Didn't play last year. John Enright in there to challenge. But powerless. Lade goes forward with great strength. Ah, that's a wonderful score by Parlade. Being more or less allowed to do as he wishes down that right-hand side. And that's a definite area of concern for Clare. It's 6-3. Nicely down from Cahill Shannon. Donal O'Sullivan towards Martin Daly, taking it chest high. He's getting so much possession against Mike Hassett. It must be a major source of concern for Paddy O'Shea. Still going through. No foul. The referee says play on. It comes to Frank Lowe. Takes it up very neatly. Seamus Moynihan alongside him. The kick. And he has put it off the post and over the bar. It's a fifth point for Clare, a first for Frank Lowen. They were talking all week about playing this man. They must be wondering now why they didn't start him.
Again, a great run by Martin Daly. Took it, sucked in three or four defenders, let the ball out to Frank Lowen, who lifted it very, very neatly. And again, onto his left foot, off the post and over the bar. But again, as I said earlier, Ger, Clare have got a grip at midfield. Kerry are struggling there at the moment.
Donal O'Sullivan, great catch. Clare will want another score, you can be sure, before half-time. That went off the boot there of Mike Hassett. Comes back to Liam Flaherty. Maurice Fitzgerald, not deceived by the bounce of the ball there. Getting away from Paddy Gallagher. Lovely control. Up towards Darrow Kinnaida. Great turn by O'Kinnaida. Coming through the heart of this defence. And he sticks one over the bar. Good finish to the half by Kerry. Darrow Kinnaida's second score. Ger Keane to take this free for Clare. Little wind to trouble him. Ball carries well, but it's gone to the right. Two wides at the start of the second half. It's been all Clare at the start of the half. First couple of minutes, but no addition to the scoring. Liam Flaherty hitting it forward towards Liam Hassett. Flaherty once again. Parlade coming in to take this into an opening. Lade cracking the shot. That is magnificent skill. A brilliant goal by Parlade. Inch perfect. Absolutely devastating. Kerry with a firm grip now.
Again, a high ball coming in, and Parlade goes up with Barry. I think it is, gets onto his left foot, gets through three tackles, and again sends a cracker of a goal into the top right hand corner. Okay, another angle coming through, and you see he jumps up, gets the ball, gets through three of them, drives straight for goals, and sends an absolute cracker beyond James Hanrahan.
Here's Donal O'Sullivan. Darrow O'Shea coming in to challenge. Nicely carried forward. Jerkeen. On to Davy John. And he's popped it over the bar. John Enright from Kilkee. Clare, stung by that magnificent goal by Parlade, have responded now with 2 points. And there's just four between them. Jerkeen rises for it, set to Eamon Green. Parlade going low to connect. Trying to keep Barry Keating away from it. Delayed. Jerkeen next in with the challenge. Then it's Gallagher in. Finally, they knock him to the ground. Some 13 metres out. Awkward enough angle. Freed to the kingdom. Well, Maurice Fitzgerald's free taking inexplicably hasn't been of the usual high order today. 3 frees taken. He's only scored from one, but he gets a second from four. And that is his 150th point in championship football in this, his 25th championship match. A goal between them again. It's a genuine monster final spectacle, this. Martin Daly. Here he comes again. Hassett nowhere to be seen, and he's kicked it over once more. Kerry by 2 points. Darrow Canada goes low, towed away from him by Alan Malone, but it comes to Liam Hassett. Mike Russell. Crowley's alongside him. Russell with the kick, and Russell with the point. Liam Hassett. Here's Eamon Green. The weariness will have rubbed off now at this stage, and Clare will have an extra pep. 5 minutes to go. Just a little under. Into Parlade from Darrow Canada. Back to John Crowley. The substitute's kick, like the other sub, has gone between the posts and over the bar. And when you can bring in two subs like that to get such good scores and turn the game in your team's direction, well, you're on a winner. We've just seen Billy O'Shea race onto the pitch there for Kerry. Racing through is Parlade. Under some pressure, he puts it over the bar. A goal and 2 points. To the credit of Parlay, the Austin Staxman from Tralee. Very pleased and proud Kerry fans there. His goal made a difference. His points certainly do as well, and it's 113 to 11. Douglas Sullivan. One last chance of an attack here for Clare. Francis McInerney knocking it on towards Corey Conway. Killian Burns was there, but so too very decisively was goalkeeper Declan O'Keefe. And it's got over the sideline. Or has it? Nearly. But not quite. And that's it! The presentation of the Munster Cup. Noel Walsh, the Clare man and Clare champion, giving it to Mike Hassett. The Munster Cup is going back to the Kingdom, second year in a row. They advance to play the Ulster champions in the All-Ireland semi-final.
We're delighted that we got through again today, you know. I think, you know, that the team certainly are progressing, and they're forming into a very nice outfit now. The National League especially had a big part in this, you know. We won the league, but it enabled us to get an amount of games, of quality games, and that helped to put the team together and to give them a more of a confident approach, I think.
Very disappointed, to say the least, I suppose. We were in the game right up towards the very end and had our chances, but unfortunately didn't take, I think, some good chances there early in the second half in particular. And then my club mate, Parlade, went down and he probably... got the goal that swung the game, I think, really.
Clare pushed us all the way, but we went in at second half. I think we started off with 3 points up, and I think maybe about 5-10 minutes in the second half, Pele gave us a goal, which really cushioned it for us. And it was important, I suppose, because knowing Clare and their typical spirit, they brought themselves back into the game within maybe two points of us. So. But the goal was a cushion for us, and it gave us a bit of breathing space, and we kind of got back into it after that, maybe a lapse after 5 or 10 minutes, and we kind of edged our way forward again, and we kind of held out. I think the last 10 minutes we finished fairly strong, so we're very pleased with the victory, yes.
Your goal after 4 minutes of the second half was an absolute peach. Can you remember the build-up?
I can't remember much about it at all, Gerard. It was a high ball kicked in. I don't even know who kicked in, and it hopped, and I jumped up for it. and I won it, and thankfully the centre just opened up for me and I put the head down and shot, and it went in.
It's no longer a two-horse race in Munster. There are definitely the three contenders.
Well, we feel like we're up there with Kerry and Cork at this stage, but it takes an almighty effort in Clare, because you know you don't have the talent and depth possibly, and you know the 25 players or thereabouts have to work very, very hard. But full credit to them, and hopefully that they'll make that breakthrough shortly.
Now you can start to look ahead to an All-Ireland semi-final and to banish the bad memory of last year.
Well, yeah, that was always the aim. The National League title was a bonus. Last year the players got a lot of unfair criticism above in Croke Park against after the Mayo game. So hopefully now we can go back there and put some unfinished business next August.
Yes, Clare making Kerry work all the way for it this afternoon, but those Kerry forwards showed that they only needed half a chance to make it count on the scoreboard. Now, when Kavanagh finish celebrating this week, they'll be taking due note of all of that, no doubt. Tony Davis, as I said there, Clare battled hard in this match, but when it counted, Kerry showed all the right class in the right places.
Well, that's right. They did work hard, they were well organised and they were motivated. But really, you need someone to score in the end of the day. Martindale was the only Clare forward really that they had, and they needed someone else. Here we see the Kerry full forward line, and in particular Maurice Fitzgerald here. He's bigger than Patrick Gallagher. He gets up and punches it with his left hand over the bar. And this is what you need to win games. You need forwards that can score. Here again, a good ball into the corner to Darragh Kinnaird, into Brian Clark, and straight over the bar. Frankie Griffin was too far off from there. Again, we have Morris breaking here into the corner. Darragh Kinnaird breaks free from his man, shows the strength that he has, and takes a good score. And the times they were dominant at foot forward reflected on when they were dominant at midfield. But overall, Clare, I think, won out the battle at midfield today.
OK, now, not just in the forward line, but also in defence. Now, you mentioned this during the live game this afternoon. You were impressed with the way Kerry defended.
Very much so. I think they learned from the Cork game, because Clare build everything from their half back line, and John Inright and Barry Keating build up. So from this insert, you can see that when Kerry lost the ball, when Clare had the ball, every one of the Kerry players became defenders. And we can see here, even their half-forwards, Liam Hassett, and in the end, William Kirby gets the ball. And that's fantastic football. And here again, this is an art that's nearly lost in football. And a terrific block down by Seamus Moynan. Saw Donal Sullivan coming up the field and went over and blocked it down. Mm-hmm. And here again, coming to the end of the game, great tackle by Mike Hassett, who really had a quiet game today. I think Martin Daly really dominated him. But when it was counted, blew him off the ball, got the ball and laid it off easily. And overall, I think Kerry, in the cold light of day, I think they're happy with their win, but they have a lot of work to do.
Man of the match from this one?
I think Pat Laid overall, he got a goal and 2 points, something which he normally doesn't is score. He worked very hard, turned John Inright the other way and made him mark him. And in the day, they score a massive goal and 2 other points. A great display.
Pat Spillane, now you know, it's Kerry and Cavan in the All-Ireland semi-final. That's going to be a great occasion, apart from anything else.
It will indeed. We need to avenge 50 years ago at the Polo Grounds. If Kerry can improve midfield, first-time ball into the forwards, match Cavan's fitness and teamwork. Luckily for Kerry, Cavan will not dominate over them physically. A lot of players are familiar with each other from last year's Under-21 final when Kerry narrowly won. A similar result would suit me fine.
Okay, Pat, Tony, thank you very much indeed. No time tonight, by the way, on the programme for Cork and Kilkenny in the hurling quarter-final. That's in Sports Stadium next Saturday. And mentally strong for this stuff, whether you're a player or a mentor. Good night.